Tech Review. Tech Review. Good morning, fellow mathematicians. Welcome back to another video. This is new. What the hell is a tech review? That actually rhymed. You know, I'm a sucker for things that make my life way easier. I mean, who isn't? Who doesn't enjoy stuff that makes your life easier on a daily basis? And for example, you can take a look at MathPix, snipping tool, and you can, as a math student, make a photo of your handwritten tools and you can turn them into LaTeX code. And there are other tools out there that can make your life way easier. For example, when handling PDF files. And this right here is a sponsored video. This video has been sponsored by iSkySoft, the creators of PDF Element Pro. And they hooked me up with a very great tool I'm using on a daily basis at the moment. I got rid of Adobe Acrobat Reader and replaced it completely with PDF Element Pro because it's just such a useful tool. You can edit PDFs with it, you can annotate them, you can copy out the pictures in there, you can get yourself some templates, you can edit forms, etc. I'm going to show you a few of the functionalities of the program in this video and I hope you are going to enjoy it and maybe it's also something for you. I really do like it. It's a really great product and yeah, it's a bit slow on its feet sometimes, but overall it's just 10 out of 10 for me. Let's get right into the video. This right here is the basic interface of PDF Element Pro. And you can already see a few things right here. You can create PDFs for yourself, you can convert PDFs, that's also really, really cool. And you can combine PDF. I really enjoy this part and I'm using this quite a lot, to be honest. When scanning and stuff, turning it into PDF files and then combining all of those together and send them to my professors, for example, if I have some essay to do. I don't know. But yeah, let us dive right in. I'm going to show you the edit features a little bit and I'm going to talk about a few things. All right, let us open up this thing right here. What you might notice now is that we can actually open up PDFs. Isn't that quite amazing? But here come in a few more features that are really interesting. As you can see up here, we have a lot of options in the, in our hub. For example, we have the edit option next to the comment and the page moving options, etc. And one very cool thing is that you can add text as much as you want. For example, we can put a little bra watermark into here, okay? You can add other watermarks also. So this is also something you can do, like semi-transparent watermarks all over the pages, just to mark out that it's your PDF element. Also, one cool thing is that this program, PDF Element Pro, is actually really good at recognizing text boxes. For example, it recognized this part right here as being pure text. And it also recognized that this thing right here is computer modern font. It's also in bold and in black. And we can put some more stuff into here. For example, this is now the derivatives, okay? So it's really good at recognizing text fields and even different kinds of form, okay? This right here is italic form and you can edit it as much as you want. Also, you can set the background, you can put watermarks in here, etc. You can put in new headers and footers, whatever you wish. You can do basically everything with it. One other really strong point is that we can get our hands at pictures. And this is something I use extremely often. So what you are going to do, you are going to get yourself the editing tool and you can actually edit pictures in here as much as you want. But one even stronger tool, like I said, that I'm using on a daily basis basically, is that we can extract images. Make a right click on here after selecting the image and now you can download it. And this is extremely helpful because sometimes you just want to get some kind of PNG out of your math text, for example, or your lecture notes, and this thing does it for you. You can easily extract pictures with it. Now we come to something that I'm also using quite often. Now that I have a lot of sponsorship deals out there and whatsoever, I actually have to get my hands on a lot of forms and I have to do a lot of signing and whatsoever over the web just because most sponsors are out there in America or something and I can't fly to America to put my little signature under each and every physically printed document. So here we go. This is also a feature that's available in Acrobat Reader, for example, but this also does it for you. So you can put your name into here, for example, bruh, okay? This right here is your new name, bruh. And yeah, you can even add a new stuff to your form. So what you can put in here are, for example, signature fields. So you can put your signature into here. and you can make digital signatures. So this is something you can do. You can put your digital signature into here. You can actually save it up and then you can just put it in the next time around. And you can edit all of those form fields that you can see at a glance. Now we are going to close the form editing, and what other things can we do? We can actually also comment. Sometimes you have to strike out something, for example, Mr. or Mrs. Felau, and you have to strike out something, and with the comment field you can actually do this. So I'm going to select the striking option and now I'm going to mark information and now it's striked. Okay, so this is something you can do, and you can add also clouds in here. So if this is something you would like to put in your PDF, you can also put in clouds. So I think this is quite cool actually. No, please stop with the clouds. I don't want any clouds anymore. After you're done with your form, filling out your form, and you would like to do a bit more editing, for example, in OpenOffice or whatsoever, it also gives you the option to convert your PDF files into a Word document, an Excel document, a PowerPoint document. Or you can also optimize your PDF. If your PDF file is way too large and you can't upload it somewhere, then well, here you go, you can just compress it a little bit. So this is something you can do. You can put it into a Word document, save it at first, and then you are basically set it. You can also edit it in Word after that. See, I have saved it as a docx document, and here, try it out for yourself. It's a really nice feature. Here is something that I'm using quite often. Sometimes I'm having some spreadsheet, for example, an Excel document, and I'm just printing it out. And all the pages are all over the place just because I suck creating nice spreadsheets. Here's one thing I'm using really often. You can actually get your hand on the pages. Okay, I'm putting the document in from before. Now, we have a few pages right here, and you can freely move them around. You can grab yourself a page and you can drag it to a different position. You can rearrange your pages at as much as you want. And I really enjoy this feature. I'm using this quite a lot. It's just extremely helpful. And before having PDF Element Pro, I actually printed out all of those pages I wanted to have in order as PDF files, okay? And then I combined them together. And the combining of PDF tools was something I had to do online because Acrobat Reader didn't really give me that option, so like the free version. Speaking of combining PDF files, it's really easy in here. So you just click on the main page on Combine PDF, and then you can add your desired stuff to it. For example, this OSHA form right here, and our fractional derivative stuff. And then you can actually select your page range, okay, so from 1 to 3 or whatsoever, and then you can simply combine those, and then you are basically settled, and it goes really fast. So this program is really fast at doing the combination. And here we go. So we have this OSHA form at the end, and here, that's also one of the nice features that I'm using on a daily basis. Basically, I said it at the beginning, we also have the option to actually select ourselves some templates, and the pro version of PDF Element Pro right here, the full version comes with over 3,000 PDF documents, if I remember correctly. And those are forms, for example, or something like gift certificates. So they come with a huge variety of stuff. And after you have gotten yourself the full version, you can actually select a lot of templates. Like the OSHA form I had before is one of those templates. And it's really nice. It provides you with a lot of stuff. And if you are a small business like me, this maybe helps you. One last thing I would like to put in here is one really important tool. Also, it's the OCR detection. So what you can do, you can put, for example, a picture into here. Okay, this has been a PNG file. And this PNG file has been turned into a PDF now, after dragging it into PDF Element Pro. Now I'm going to perform the OCR. I'm going to save it as a new PDF file. After conversion, I'm going to click through a few things. It's going to take like a second. It's really fast. And now it actually detected all the text on this picture that we originally had. Remember, this has been a PNG file. So now you can actually edit the text yet again. This is the OCR detection and it's really powerful. You can even grab yourself handwritten notes, okay, for example with your tablet, and it's going to recognize your handwriting to a certain extent. And it's a really useful tool, and now you can simply edit all the stuff yet again. You can put your brow watermark into here and then you are basically settled. This is a really cool feature and I'm using this too. This is something I'm using to actually make my handwritten notes being recognized by this program right here. And then you can save it as a PDF file, Word file yet again. And yeah, it just works out really nicely. If PDF Element Pro sounds like it's something for you, take a look at top of the description. There will be a link to a 50% discount code. One half the price of the original product. It's a real steal at the moment and it's way more affordable than Adobe Acrobat Reader. And I for myself enjoy using it way more because it has way more options that you can make use of. Try it out for yourself and support the channel this way. And I thank you guys for watching. Up until next video, have a flammable day. Ciao.